Hello, my name is Yalile Villalba and I'm a business management. Are you looking for a career? Business management could be your option. Sometimes it's difficult to make decisions in life. And the most important and currently complicated is the one about your career. But don't worry, I can help giving you some advices that will lead you in that decision. Today, we are talking about business management and the following topics. First, the main meaning of business management. Second, the difference between business management and economic science. Third, why is important business management in Colombia? Fourth, what characteristics you should have for being a good business management? Fifth, business management and the society 2.0 or digital society. Sixth, opportunities and risks of being a business management. Have you ever thought about how you organize your daily life? Are you planning your school's activities, your free times, vacations, or just go by the way? Have you ever thought about the advantages of developing and achieving personal goals? Let's begin. First of all, you should know that all the vocabulary using here relating with business management are not new at all. So my first advice for all of you is to be willing to read a lot and learning every time that you can about topics relevant to it. First, the main meaning of business management. In order to give an appropriate meaning for business management, we should pay attention to the main expositor of the management theory, Alberto Giovinato, 2005. He gives a specific definition for administration in his book, Introducing to the General Theory of Administration. It's the process of planning, organizing, leading and controlling the use of resources in order to achieve the organizational goals. Related to business in themselves, that definition takes the actions of plan, organize, lead and control of all companies' areas of efforts and all its levels, so that achieve the goals in the best way, keeping in mind the current situation inside and outside the company and guarantee competitiveness in business's world. By the chance, the Giovinato's definition about administration sounds familiar to you? If yes, that's why you manage your life day by day. You have a routine that could be a plan in order to achieve different goals, even if those aren't so relevant. For example, arriving on time to school or another place. Also, you organize your activities for doing those in a specific hour. You have the ability of doing those activities with specific parameters and getting the wanted results. That ability is lead. Finally, usually you and me review the results that we get after doing something. Doesn't matter if it's big or small, significant or not. That's what we call control. Second, the difference between business management and economic science. First of all, we must remember that business management and economic science belong to the same social science branch, and in some cases, the occupational profiles coincide. Both sciences study the appropriate uses of resources in order to get the maximum benefit for a community. As we can see, the main character of business management and economic sciences studies are humans. Our logical behavior when the resources are not enough, and the way in which we propose solutions. For example, decisions, strategies, policies, and even laws. This figure is showing us the correlation that exists between economics and business management, in order that all is influenced by the humans and community. As we can see, social science, economics, and business management acts like agents in order to produce products or services using resources, distributing it, and finally give a benefit that should be equal for the whole population. The Otto Beisheim School of Management gives us a clear difference between business management and economic science. Business management: plan, support, and analyze internal process. Principle: all goods are essentially scarce in that they require efficient handling. Make good decisions inside the enterprises. Focus on profits and low costs. Ensure the suitable enterprises function. Analyzes supply, demand, and profits. Occupational application: study legal aspects of the enterprise, corporate finances, marketing, and human resources. Economics: focusing on individual companies and examine entire economic areas. Primarily based on statistics and create recommendations relating to economic matters. Satisfy the enterprise's needs and allow its broad growth. Focus on production, distribution, and consume. Ensure the correct production process and products distribution within the economic conditions. Analyzes employment, taxes, stock market, current government's politics, GDP, inflation, etc. Occupational application: studies how the market, financing system, and competence works. Make decisions, analyze, and advisory the enterprises in the law enforcement. Until this point, I would like that you could analyze if you can visualize yourself working inside a company, but knowing that all of the efforts that it does will result in a big benefit for the entire society. Your ideas, skills, abilities could be useful for an organization in order to achieve more than profits. Let's continue. Third, why is important business management in Colombia? In this point, we are going to refer about three focuses: what our country needs, what Colombian company needs, and what the professional careers offers in itself. What our country needs. The most important reason is because the continued growth in the number of companies created, despite of the obviously economic crisis in our country due to the COVID-19. Between January and March 2021, 96,431 companies were created. It is a 9.3% more than the same period on 2020. Because the economic sectors affect with the crisis, which means an incredible opportunity to be part of the revival of the economy. In tourism sector, 1,009 companies were closed. In land transportation sector, 1,058 companies were closed. In industry sector, 7,313 companies were closed. And in civil construction sector, 1,086 companies were closed. What Colombian companies need. According with Semana Magazine online version 2020, business management is the best option for starting an entrepreneurship, manage the organizational change or getting better different professionals' profiles. The business management schools in Colombia have increased the number of their graduate professionals, going from 16,624 in 2001 to 143,392 in 2017. And even so, it is still the career with more occupational opportunities. Carlos Restrepo, the Externado University's Director of Research in Area of Business Management School, said that there is something that the business administrator does that no other professional does, and is thinking about business models. And even they don't have enough knowledge about engineering, chemistry, and other technical processes. They found the people who actually do, and they know how to involve them in order to make that model bigger. Alejandro Beltrán, the Externado University's Dean of Business Management School, explains that there are a lot of people that are promoted to managerial positions, and then they realize they don't have competence to leading, and so they're looking for an MBA. Asobancaria, in its Semana Económica 2018 magazine, said that the Colombian business structure is composed mainly by small businesses. Those productive units don't have more than 200 workers and a small asset structures, but they represent the 40% of the GDP and the 81% of the formal work structure of the country. In that sense, those kind of business transform themselves into a pillar of the stagnant and economic Colombian growth. Besides, those businesses need young and open-minded people that can learn about their environment, looking and taking opportunities. The essence of the success for the small business under the leading of young people is the previous experience of the economic sector where they began as entrepreneurs, and obviously the college degree. Portfolio Magazine online version 2019 said that the currently global situation with a large number of new companies, mostly entrepreneurs, needs at the same time a high X number of people with solving problems abilities and ensure the progress, considering values such as sustainability, innovation, and efficiency. Viviana Vélez, academic vice chancellor of the La Gran Colombia University, added that the companies have changed a lot, and it's necessary to understand the new market dynamics, new global technological trends, and the challenges that the globalization progress involve. What the professional careers offers in itself. Portfolio 2019 said that the business management offers the constantly content evolution, mainly because of the market's dynamism, global economy, the Colombian revolutions, and the new professional profiles of the youth. Vélez add that the nowadays the company are dynamic and require constantly innovations, which means have a greater chance of access to a better life conditions and higher pay job aspirations. Besides, she explains that the career allow the development of a creative way of thinking, lead the students to propose solutions to needs created because of the globalization process, promote that the student develops managerial and personal skills, be able of leading the organizational change process, empowering high specialized professional teams. That means the business management should be able of using wisely the knowledge and skills of their teams so that the company could achieve its goals. Fourth, what characteristics you should have for being a good business management? Until this point, probably you are discovering that this career needs some characteristics or a specific professional profile, skills, and abilities that a student like you is supposed to have. In this way, we are going to review some authors that suggest some skills and ability that a business management should have. We see before that the globalization process, mainly in our country, means a very hard and also fast organizational transformation inside the companies. They went from a local market to a global one, so aggressive and competitive, highly technical and with a vision to innovation and added value in all the processes. As social science, business management will depend on the personality of the manager, his feelings, values, way of thinking, and more. In this way, Robert L. Katz, 1974, said that the success of the managerial activity is because the job performance, how he or she treats the people in different situations and their personality characteristics. Resuming. The success is the result of what he does, not what he is. That means that it isn't enough the career degree, it's what you can do with the technical or theoretical knowledge in order to lead the company, improving, getting better, or innovating all the processes inside it. What is a skill? What means that I have a skill? A skill is the action of transform the knowledge into action in order to getting expected or planned results. For cats, there are three important skills for the successful administrative performance: technical, human, and conceptual. Technical skills for the know-how of different processes in all the company levels. Human skills for working with others and being an effective group member, or if the manager is in a high or top level, to being able to build cooperative effort within the team he is leading. Conceptual skills for recognizing the interrelationship between various factors involved in a specific situation in a specific time, which lead him or her to take the action that achieve the maximum good for the entire organization. This author also explains that these skills are useful in a specific organization level because they vary according with the administrative responsibility level in which the manager is. For a better understanding of this graphic, we must know that the business management is the main responsible of taking decisions and developing strategies in order to achieving goals. So, depending on the level in which he is, the three skills should be used. So, for example, in the lower organizational levels, the manager should use technical skills in order to lead and teaching the know-how of the process, human skills in this case, principally the ones related with working with objects, procedures, and numbers. In the middle or high levels, both technical and human skills should be used, because in this level, often the strategies of achieving organization goals are defining and implementing. The manager should know the technical part for looking efficient with high quality and low costs, and human part in order to motivate in leading, teaching, and training people to meet goals effectively and efficiently. Finally, the top level of management should collect all the information that he could all over the company in order to analyze the environment, the global market, the risks and opportunities, and other factors, because the manager in this point is responsible for remaining of the company through the time, making it competitive, capable of staying afloat during crisis. Enduring managerial abilities. Do you want to remain in time as well the organizations want it? Well, here are three abilities that you should consider for not being out of fashion. According with Chiavenato, 2005, these three abilities would help you to developing as the companies do, making you a priceless resource that the organization must have. Knowledge. It's the entire collection of data, concepts, ideas, experiences, and learnings that a manager has about his or her professional specialism. Knowledge changes every moment, quickly, because of the transformation and innovations with increasing intensity, so the manager should update and renew it. Perspective. It's the ability of putting the knowledge in action, transforming the theory into the practice, applying the knowledge to the situations, analysis, problems, solutions, and direct the business. It's putting on practice the abstract ideas and concepts inside the manager's mind and notice the opportunities. Attitude. It's the manager's personal behavior facing the work's situations. It's the way of leading, motivating, communicating, and making the things happen. Involves the impulse and determination of innovating, the conviction of continuing getting better, the entrepreneurial spirit, dissatisfaction with the current problems. But the most important thing is that the ability of working with others and trusting them. I must say that these abilities and skills aren't a magic formula for getting the company's success. Fail should consider as a treasure. an opportunity for increasing our knowledge. Adding experience is like Napoleon Hill said, most great people have achieved their greatest success just one step beyond their greatest failure. Reflection. What is your attitude when you have failed? Do you consider failure as the end of everything? Fifth, business management in the society 2.0 or digital society. According with Dr. Alberto Ramirez Martinez, 2016, the concept of society 2.0 shouldn't be understood just in a technological development way. We must consider this term in its social meaning, in which a community understands collaboration as extends social value, social networks as a means of interaction and a contact opportunity. In this society, the intermediaries agents almost don't exist. The relation between producer and consumer is so close that nowadays a client can personalize the product or service that will satisfy his needs. In this new way of connecting people have developed as an intrinsically and voluntarily society building, four behaviors inside the digital space. Kane et al. 2014. Circulate. Forwarding links with possibly interest contents for others. Collaborate. Producing and sharing information in teamwork through platforms or websites, for example, Wikipedia. Create. Producing and exchanging media content through platforms as YouTube. Connect. Through social networks, Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, or through digital communities as games clans or fandoms. As we can see, being part of a participate culture gives new opportunities and change the participants' expectations about how to approach different relevant activities inside a society, as work, learning, politics, consume, and a relevant market participation. In that sense, we can identify three relevant changes in the managerial process. First, community management, social network. Dr. Ramirez gives his assessment related with the current way of socialization inside a community. He said that digital platforms facilitate the creation of social interaction networks, the information access that allows the digital identity construction, active participation inside the web, and having a social interaction extension, complementary to the ones that we have outside the net. Thanks to these social interactions, a community expands. It turns into a mass fall of opinions and experiences, able for taking decisions. In a nutshell, it influences. José Alberto Gómez Isasi, Associate Professor of the Universidad Autónoma de Tamaulipas, talks about the phenomenon called production socialization, in which we stop consuming products to produce them. This digital net that connects people make possible the distribution of the information, knowledge, and the democratization of creative production content. This means that in this moment, all the industrial process or know-how is available for everyone. In order to capture the consumer attention, the companies use the creativity, design, and aesthetic content. For these purposes, the appropriate uses of social network could help, mainly because the digital tools that this offers and the easy access to them. Here we can see how the manager functions start to be more specialized. Also, it includes the necessity of learning about new marketing strategies and, inside the company, a new job, community manager, who will the person responsible to ensure the presence of the company in social networks. So he or she must design and identify for it in the net a very specific schedule in order to give enough and relevant information to consumers about services, products, or new business that could be interesting for them. Second, e-commerce, a new commercial relation form. Having clarified the new form of communication in Society 2.0, we can understand better why a lot of companies nowadays are modifying his business model in order to evolve with the context in which they are. For example, About commercial relations, considered the social network as the principal communication media, it's obvious that the company wants to be closer to his consumers and potential clients. They develop or purchase a platform that manages the sales and the payments. That platform also includes a digital showcase in which the consumers could watch the products or services, their characteristics, the stock and prices. Also, it's an easy way in which discount campaigns could be done, giving discount vouchers or memberships in order to get more benefits of the company. Advantages: global market access, increase the products and services offers, cost and expenses reduction. Disadvantages: existence of a lot of competitive companies, security problems. Profitability takes time to arrive. It needs a big investment in marketing at the beginning. Third, crossing borders, access to global market. As we see until this point, the Society 2.0 involves relevant processes, mainly the ones related with communication, but these open lines are not just inside the country, chiefly is for having communication with other countries. This privilege is not only for companies that actually have done since a long time ago. Nowadays, individuals are in contact with people of different nationalities, speaking or understanding a little of other languages, are learning about other cultures, behaviors, and values. What's more, consumers are knowing and actually demanding products or services that they found on the internet, and sometimes they make an investment in order to import them. It means a challenge for national companies in order to innovate those products or services and make easily and low cost acquire them. But for organizations, it also means a great possibility for making presence outside the country, increasing their demand, giving them the opportunity of diversifying the portfolio. 6. Conclusions, opportunities and risks of being a business management. Sanabria et al. 2007 researchers at the El Rosario University mentioned the following risks. A. Risks related with the country context. Scientific and technological lag. Colombia just have the 0.0% of world scientifics. National investment in science and technology is just 0.5% of the GDP. Technological dependence and low productivity. It limits the competitiveness of Colombian companies, compared with developed countries, increasing the inequality gap. Neoliberal policies. Colombian companies were affected by the globalization process, but a lot of companies couldn't develop the productive and technological level in order to achieve the international standards. B. Risks related with the global context. Development of a new environment of unequal perspective. Pressure of the biggest companies to governments, from the rich countries to poor ones, the technological revolution and information technology develop. C. Risks related to the country's productive apparatus. MIPIMES, or small business. As we said before, this kind of business represents the 40% of the GDP and the 81% of the formal work structure of the country. These business have some problems, for example, low level of productivity, limited competitiveness, isolation and scarce individual supply to conquer the national market and consequently the international. Informal business, low sales and profitability levels, focus on selling products with little added value and low management capacity. These businesses do not set goals for growth and development, and they don't manage efficiently their resources. On the other hand, we have some opportunities as business management. Evaluating the real purpose for starting a business, because a small business can continue thinking small. Having goals looking for international markets are essential in order of making them enduring on time. Updating knowledge constantly so that the company can face the market dynamism. Researching the demand always, in order to be able to innovate the product or service and be competitive always. Understand that the business beginning is not always easy and the success don't come easy or fast. Strengthening a company requires time, effort, and dedication. professional opportunities. Working in every level inside an organization, you'll be able of leading any group supporting the highest level of management will be the opportunity for apply your college knowledge. Well, I hope this video has helped you for making a wisely decision. And if you already decided to study business management, let me know for sharing my personal experiences. See you later.